acceleration due to gravity and you are aware of this word acceleration due to gravity is the acceleration with which the every object is being attracted towards the earth then the acceleration with which the body is getting attracted towards the earth yours that is acceleration due to gravity as it is acceleration so the units and dimensions for small g they will be the same as you know acceleration due to gravity it is written by small g and the SI unit will be same as that of your acceleration only so meter per second square and the dimensional formula also you are aware of that is m naught l t minus 2 so whenever you do any quantity you should be knowing its units and dimensions of course it is a vector quantity all these three things should be clear to you and when I'm the acceleration due to gravity I want to find its relation with the capital G which is the gravitational constant we have discussed in the Newton's law of gravitation now what it is if this is your earth I have taken this as the earth and we assume the whole mass of the body is lying at the center of the earth it is attracting the body with the force if the mass of the body which is being attracted towards the earth is small m capital M I have taken as the mass of the earth then the force of attraction between them that is given by the Newton's law of gravitation that means your F it is equals to g mm upon r square if r is taken as the radius and I assume that the body is on the surface of earth so if the body is on the surface of earth then this distance between the body and the earth it is equals to the radius of the earth which is equals to r now if I write by my previous knowledge by using the Newton's second law if I write the value of the force this is given by your F it is equals to ma and a here it is equals to acceleration due to gravity so I can write F it is equals to mg and if I equate both these things I'm getting the equation with me which is relating small g and capital g that is equals to g m upon small g it is equals to capital g m upon r square this is the case when I'm taking the body on the surface of earth now second case with you is if I assume that the body is not on the surface of earth but it is little above the surface of earth and if I assume the body here above the surface of earth then what it is this distance between the center of the earth and the body center it is equals to small r I'm assuming then of course you can use the Newton's law of gravitation to write the equation that is given by F it is equals to capital G capital M small m upon r square and then accordingly whatever comes the question accordingly you can work out with the things and you can find the force we can even find the capital small g now most of the times we take when we have to assume or calculate the mass and density of the earth we assume that the given body is on the surface of earth and this is the relation bache between small g and capital g you should be able to compare both the things at the end of this lecture you should be in a position to compare the means the similarity as well as the differences you should be able to tell between the small g and capital g this is our aim in the beginning of lecture this relation we have simply calculated by our previous knowledge that small g it is equals to capital g m upon r so from here if I want to write the mass of the earth I can write that is coming out to be g r square upon capital g now I know on the surface of earth the value of small g it is equals to 9.8 meter per second square and radius of the earth that is equals to 6400 kilometer. If I write it in terms of meter, I'm able to write 6.4 into 10 to the power 6 meter. Capital G value is also known to me, that is 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 newton meter square per kilogram square. If I put all these values in this formula for the M, I'm getting on calculations the mass of the earth, which is coming out to be is 6 into 10 raised to the power 24 kilogram. And when we are talking about the earth, we are assuming that the density, average density of the earth is uniform. Now, if I want to find that density, what is that uniform density that I have written as the average density, then the formula for density is already known to you, that is equals to density, it is equals to mass upon volume. So from here you can write the formula for mass, that is equals to volume into density. Now if I have taken capital R as the radius, then volume I can write from this your formula, I can write volume, that is equals to 4 by 3 pi r cube, that is the volume. And if I take the volume into density, then that becomes equals to your capital M. So this is your capital M, that is equals to 4 by 3 pi r cube into rho. As V, it is equals to 4 by 3 pi r. So I can write the value of mass. And so I know this is the value of the mass and density I can calculate. If you put the value of mass from your previous knowledge, that is equals to gr square upon capital G. And for volume, you will be putting it equals to 4 by 3 pi r cube. And then you calculate this r square and r cube, one r is left. This 3 is coming in numerator. I'm getting 3g upon 4 by 4 pi g r. So this is the value of the density with me. And if I put the value of small g, capital G and radius of earth, I can get the value of the density, which is the uniform density. It is coming out to be 5500 kilogram per meter cube. That is the uniform density of the earth or average density of the earth. So we can use this value in this questions directly also, or otherwise if they ask, you can calculate the things by putting the values. This was all about the mass and density of the earth if I'm taking. Now what happens when I'm moving above the surface of earth? This is the surface of earth, I'm moving above, or I'm going inside the surface of earth, then what is found that acceleration due to gravity, it changes. So what, how it is changing, we have to study different cases that variation of acceleration due to gravity. Now, if I'm on the surface of earth, that is we are taking as the standard value 9.8 meter per second square, but we have to go in, if I'm going at the higher altitudes, it means higher heights. Altitude means height, you can say, and your altitude or height, the meaning is same. So when I'm moving above the surface of earth, then on the surface of earth, this formula is already with me, that is small g, it is equals to capital G m upon r square. Now if I'm taking the body of mass m here at a height h above the surface of earth, then what will be the value of g, acceleration due to gravity at this distance? By using again the Newton's law of gravitation, I'm getting gm upon small r square. If I take this distance as small r, if this distance is taken as small r, then small r can be written as capital R plus h. And then you can work out with the things, and you are getting the value of gh, it is equals to yours gm upon r plus h whole square. And if I divide both these equations, I'm getting gh upon g, it is equals to gm upon r plus h whole square into r square upon gm. So this is, we are assuming if height above the surface of earth is comparable to the radius of Earth. Then I can use this formula directly, or I can write it in this form, because gm will get cancelled. I will get it in this form, gh upon capital G, it is equals to r square plus r plus h whole square. So this formula you can keep in with your mind if h is comparable to r. Now what it is, if, because otherwise we have come to know this radius is 6400 kilometer, and when I'm going even at the hill stations, I'm not going at that particular height of this comparison. So the height is most of the times less than the radius of the earth. In that case, you can rewrite this equation. If I rewrite by taking r square common here, I can write it as r square upon r square into 1 plus h upon r whole square of this. So this equation can be written like this. Now, because h is less than r, then I can use the binomial theorem, because I know the binomial theorem states that 1 plus x power n, it is equals to 1 plus nx. Now, this power here is, I can write it as here's 1 plus h upon r power minus 2, because r square is getting cancelled, and this power minus 2 will come in multiplication with this h upon r. So I'm getting gh upon g, it is equals to 1 minus 2h upon r if h is very, very less than the radius of Earth. Or I can write gh, it is equals to g into 1 minus 2h upon r. So this is second way of writing for the case when h is less than r. So these both the equations should be clear according to the question. You can see, of course, here, if you wish, you can see that gh is coming out to be less than g. Gh is coming out to be less than g. It means when you are going at higher altitudes, the value of acceleration due to gravity, it decreases. And of course, we can do with the graph plotting also, that I will do it at the end of this lecture. Now, the second case with you is that if I go inside the earth, it means now and the body here is moving inside the earth through a depth d, then I want to study the variation of acceleration due to gravity with depth. So when I'm moving at some depth d, then I can see that the body now here will come here. The body here it comes in place of here on the surface of Earth. Earlier it was here on the surface of Earth. Now I'm bringing it here. On the surface of Earth, again, the formula is known to you on the surface of Earth, that small g is equals to capital Gm upon r square. But what happens when I'm bringing to a depth d, then of course acceleration due to gravity will change, because the distance from the center of Earth is getting changed. Earlier it is capital R. Now it will remain r minus d only, because I am at this. At the same time, now the whole mass of the body is not going to contribute for drifting, because I am coming inside the earth, and we are assuming the uniform density of the earth is there. So mass is uniformly distributed. So when I am getting inside the earth, mass is also getting changed. When I am on the surface of earth, then mass, I can write it like m, it is equals to here's 4 by 3 pi r cube rho. This we have already seen. Now, if I'm coming inside the earth, then the mass m dash, I'm writing 4 by 3 pi. Now, the radius of this circle will become r minus d. It means r minus d whole cube, and uniform density, that is rho. So, I can write the value of m dash, which is equals to 4 by 3 pi r minus d whole cube upon whole cube into rho. So m dash is 4 by 3 pi r minus d whole cube rho. Now on the surface of earth, the formula is with me. G at the surface of earth is capital Gm upon r square. If I put the value of m here, that is 4 by 3 pi r cube rho, then this g in multiplication and r square in denominator will come as it is. And you can see one, this r square is getting cancelled, and I'm left with only one r. So g at the surface of earth, if I am writing in terms of density, then I am able to write it as 4 by 3 pi r g into rho. This is the formula with me. Now same lines, if I want to write for g at a depth d here at this point, then you can see g m dash upon r minus d whole square. It is equals to, now you can put the value of m dash from here and you can calculate the values and I am getting 4 by 3 pi r minus d g into. So if I divide both these equations gs and gd, then I am able to get yours, this is of course g at the surface of earth, then I am able to get gd upon gs, it is equals to r minus d upon r. Or I can write gd, it is equals to g into 1 minus d upon r. Because it means now here, again, you can see gd, it is equals to g minus something. So gd is again going to be less than g at the surface of earth. It means whether I'm moving inside the earth or I'm going away from the surface of earth, both the cases, your acceleration due to gravity is decreasing. This is to be noted. Now, if I bring the body at the center of the earth, it means here, if I bring the body at the center of earth, it means I'm bringing inside the earth through this distance capital R, then what is going to happen, you have to see that as a question or otherwise as a special case also you can take, that when the body is at the center of earth, then D it is becoming equals to the radius of the earth, and gd, by putting the value of d equals to r in this formula, I'm getting 1 minus 1. So g multiplied with 0, so I'm getting g at the center of earth is coming out equals to 0. Now if they ask what is the weight of the body at the center of earth, then you should be knowing the relation between the mass and the weight. You know mass is the quantity of matter contained in the body, it is not changing, remains the same at all the places, but weight, it is getting changed with the change in acceleration due to gravity. So when you are moving the body up, you are going on the moon or you are going on some other planet, according to the acceleration due to gravity, the weight gets changed, but mass of the body remains the same. So here when gd is coming out equals to 0, then weight of the body will also becomes equals to 0. But of course, the mass of the body is never zero. That you must know as your previous knowledge. You know the difference between mass and weight of the body. Now, one question with you is that you have to find the relation between the height and the depth for the same change in acceleration due to gravity. It means by how much height, if I move supposedly by h height, what is the value of acceleration due to gravity here? Or if I go inside the earth through the depth d, then also the value of acceleration due to gravity becomes same. So for the same change in g, it means gh should be equals to gd. And these formulas are there with me. Then if I equate gh and gd, I will be able to get the relation between d and h. So I'm getting d equals to twice of h. But of course, you should know that this is true only when h is less than of the earth is ellipse. Now, if I want to see the variation of acceleration due to gravity with shape of the earth, then the actual shape is ellipse. It's not circle. So rp, it is found to be less than re. Because this is equatorial axis, this is polar axis. Equatorial axis, that is the major axis we have taken. Polar axis, that is the minor axis. Rp is less than Re, but I know the relation between G and R, that G is equals to capital Gm upon R square. It means small g is inversely proportional to R square. So if R is less, G will be more and vice versa. So I will be getting that acceleration due to gravity at poles is greater than acceleration due to gravity at equator. Go with the variation of g with latitude. Latitude means rotation of the earth. Because when the earth is rotating, every time the position is getting changed. and latitude, if I'm at this position, supposedly at this point, then if I'm joining this point, which is made by the this position, this line which is joining the place with the center of Earth, it is making with equatorial plane, that angle is termed as latitude. So that is the variation of G with latitude. Here we are denoting it by lambda. And I have the previous knowledge that when I make the body to move in the circular path, if I'm taking it, then of course the weight of the body mg is acting towards the center of Earth. And if this circle for this particular position I'm taking, then centripetal force mr omega square is providing you the centripetal force, and centrifugal force, which is going to keep, that is of course a pseudo force, we are considering it to make our study easy. Because if I stop at this point, then the force which will be acting to balance it, that is equals to same magnitude mr omega square. And if this angle I'm taking equals to lambda, then this angle is also equals to lambda. And if I resolve this here's centrifugal force into components, I'm getting mr omega square cos lambda this side, which is balancing omega square sine lambda is there. So basically, when we want to deal with the net force which is acting towards the center of Earth at this point, that is given by mg minus mr omega square cos lambda. And you can find the value of g lambda, g because of latitude, that is coming out to be g minus r omega square cos lambda. Now if you are at the equator here, then lambda will become equals to zero. So g lambda, you can see the value at equator, g minus r omega square. And when you are at poles, this lambda will be 90 degree. So cos 90 will be zero. So g lambda will be equals to g at poles. I can say this, g lambda equals to g at poles, because lambda it is equals to 90 degree at poles. And if you find at equator, then of course it is g minus something. So you can see that at equator the value of acceleration due to gravity is less than the poles. You want to do the graph plotting with the distance. You can see the graph plotting with the distance. If I'm at the center of Earth, I'm going till the surface of Earth, it means distance r equals to capital R, then g is directly proportional to capital R minus d, or if I'm writing in terms of small r, then it is proportional to small r. I will be getting a straight line. At the center of Earth, it is finding, means at the surface of Earth, it is finding the maximum value. At the center of Earth, it is zero. Here, this is at the surface of Earth, that is getting equals to the maximum value. And further, if you go to the higher heights, higher altitudes, then the value of acceleration due to gravity decreases as per this relation, g is inversely to r square. So this graph, of course, you should be able to do the graph plotting. Earth is not, you are going to keep things up to this. Thank you, everyone.